Hey, morning guys. How are you guys doing? I hope you guys are having a fabulous day. I'm back to saying I hope you guys are staying warm. Weather. I told you, I jinxed myself. Ever since I put the ACs in, it has been 30 degrees at night, 50 degrees during the day. I also want to say that and apologize for yesterday and my rant, and if that offended any of you guys, because I know that I obviously know that I do not share the same feelings or ideologies or political values of a great number of you. And I'm not here to offend anyone. And what I was saying was bipartisan in every respect of the way. If our president was a Democrat, still doing what he was doing, I would have the same feelings. It's about the man, not about the political party, I guess is what I'm trying to say. But at any rate, I apologize because I shouldn't be using this platform or my platform to basically rant about how I feel about things. That's not what this is for. So I apologize for that. Now, moving on. Today is Monday. Monday is Reactors Day, and this is gonna be kind of a weird one, I guess. Okay. So, God, I don't know why, but I've been like on this Quentin Tarantino like thing. I don't know, lately, over the last week or so. And I've seen pretty much everything he's ever put out, but I just want to see it again. So, I've been watching a lot of Quentin Tarantino lately. I found, as I'm watching them, I'm thinking about the fact that his movies have fantastic soundtracks. I don't know if you guys have ever realized that his movies really do. So it led me to the internet to see if anybody else had actually ever posted it about that, the soundtracks of his movies. And yes, in fact, many music magazines, many articles had been posted about his soundtracks that he uses for his movies and the way he actually goes about getting them too as well. There's like this whole big thing about it. It's really like something people talk about. Anyway, I found this one article in a music magazine. I'm not going to say the name of the magazine because I'm not here to promote it, but it actually listed the top five songs from Quentin Tarantino movies, all of his movies. These are the top five songs. Quentin Tarantino likes to use older songs. He also likes to steal songs. They said that he steals songs from other soundtracks and movies, not from people. Meaning if he's watching a movie and he's like, "Oh, I like that song." He'll take that song and put it in his movie. So he'll do that. It's just really kind of crazy how he goes about his soundtracks. Anyway, that know more about that. So what we are doing today is the top five songs from Quentin Tarantino movies. And if you're a Quentin Tarantino fan, then you'll appreciate all of them and you'll recognize them right off the bat because you'll know. And you'll know what movie too. So the first one we are doing is George Baker, released in 1970. It's a little green bag. And what movie is it from, guys? Yes, Reservoir Dogs. But Reservoir Dogs actually came out in 92. So this is a 20-year-old song, 22-year-old song. And I told you, he likes to use older music. Now, this is a really old song. But anyway, so this is George Baker, Little Green Bag from the Reservoir Dogs soundtrack, 1992. Let's get it.
My mind outside in the night, outside in the day. a little green back. Got to find just a kind of losing my mind. Out of sight in the night, out of sight in the day. Looking back on a track, gonna do it my way. Looking back on a track for a little, little green back. Got to find just a kind of losing my mind.
Okay, that was awesome. Okay, every time I hear that song, I instantly think of Reservoir Dogs. Why? Because that's the only time I've ever heard that song. And since I've seen Reservoir Dogs, I haven't heard that song since. And then I hear it and I don't hear it again until I watch Reservoir Dogs again. So I think it's awesome. I like the funk in it. I love it. I don't know. It's like a mix between poppy 50s kind of thing, the teeny bop vibe, mixed in with like just this jazzy funk beat. I mean, it's just a really good song. Yeah, they were right to pick this song. This is a really good song. And it was perfect in the movie for what it was. And yeah, love it. I hope you guys liked it as well. You guys tell me what you guys think are the best five songs from Quentin Tarantino movies. Any of them. You can pick any of his movies. Actually, no. You have to stop at Django, because that's where this stops, is at Django. So that's where you guys have to stop at. Anything after that? No. So anyway, you guys have a fantastic day. We are doing a live tonight. If you go to the community page on my channel, there is a poll up there to pick a start time. I had put down 8 o'clock, and a couple of people had said, some of my overseas people had said, well, that's in the middle of the night for us. So I had then put up a poll for a different start times for people to either write in or to put on the poll. So put on, no, they're not going to become strippers. They're going to actually vote on the poll. Okay. So you guys, if you want to have an actual weigh in on what time the live is going to start, go over there and vote or leave a note or something. But we are going to have a live this evening. There you go. So have a fantastic day. Please remember to comment, like, subscribe if you have not already. And what else, guys? Yes, it's all about love in 2020 and beyond. And what else? Take care of each other, please. Because nobody else is going to. Ciao.